Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We welcome you to worship on this first Sunday of Advent. Happy New Year. Turn your attention briefly to the announcements found in the bulletin. I remind you that there's a new Advent formation for adults that begins this Wednesday, 11 o'clock. Back by popular demand, we will take a look at the mini series, The Chosen, the Christmas portion. And then what we will do is have scripture and discussion based on the Christmas portion of The Chosen. That's in the morning. In the evening, have an opportunity for a family formation at 7 o'clock. You will see noted what we will do. We will roll up our sleeves, as it were, and do items that will relate to outreach. For instance, this first Wednesday, they'll be putting together cookies and boxes and invitations that will go to the congregation. The next Wednesday, we will create Christmas cards, which will go to the youth of Sisu, and then on the 18th, create fleece scarves, which will go to our homeless brothers and sisters when we pass out the breakfast burritos on Christmas Eve. So mark that on your calendar. You can come to the morning session and or the evening session. Also remind you, continuing to gather up pledges for 2025, the mission and the ministry of this congregation. If you need a pledge card, be sure to ask an usher. There are pledge cards available in the narthex, or you can use the QR code to scan your pledge for 2025. Also remind you, lots that's taking place in the life of this parish during Advent. Next Sunday, we have our St. Nicholas Sunday, a visit from the Bishop of Myra, so you don't want to miss that. And then the following Sunday, on the 15th, we have confirmation led by our own Bishop Polson Reed, confirmation, reaffirmation, and baptism. And so he will be at the 8:30 service as well as this service. We have a sizable confirmation class again. I know you guys always sigh about that. You say, oh my gosh, we've got to pack a lunch. I think it's a wonderful thing. As I was talking to Bishop Paulson last week, when a congregation has over 5, 10, 15 people to be confirmed into the life of the congregation. So you don't want to miss the 15th of December. It will be a great Sunday. Invite family members and friends. So you see what's taking place on the back of your announcement sheet. You see everything that's taking place in the life of this parish during Christmas tide. On Christmas Eve, two services, 5 o'clock and also 10 o'clock. 5 o'clock will be a quiet, simple service, Christmas around the creche. 10 o'clock will be a service with brass and choir, organ, incense, a traditional candlelight service. So mark those on your calendar. And then you will note what we did last year. We'll do the same thing this year. Beginning on Christmas Day, we will have services at 12 noon. So there's a service on the 25th, 26th, 27th, 28th. On the 29th, there's one service at 10 o'clock. There's a service on Wednesday, January the 1st. And then we culminate our Christmas celebration on the Feast of Epiphany, January the 6th. So be sure to take this home, put it on your bulletin board or your refrigerator so you can note the schedule during Christmas tide. Now, as we prepare to worship God in the beauty of holiness, let us affirm the mission statement of this congregation as it's found in your bulletin on page 3 in English and Spanish. Together, we are an enthusiastically welcoming and inviting Christian community committed to the unity of all people with God through Christ. As we say each and every time we gather in this sacred space, welcome, welcome to
worship.
Indeed.
Blessed are you, holy and living one. Repent, for the kingdom of God has come near.
Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may depart.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
And the congregation is invited to participate in the ancient tradition of nesting. If you haven't had an opportunity already to pick up a raffia twist, we encourage you to do so as you make your way down the side aisles into the narthex and then up the center aisles. We invite those who are on my right-hand side to please place your raffia twist in the manger. Those who are on my left-hand side, please place the raffia twist on the black plastic area so that you don't have to, you know, crisscross the aisle, and we can participate in this wonderful tradition of nesting as we prepare for the birth of Jesus the Christ. When you return to your seats, please remain standing, singing the two gathering songs. We begin.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, give us grace to cast away the works of darkness and put on the armor of light now in the time of this mortal life in which your Son, Jesus Christ, came to visit us in great humility, that in the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge both the living and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal through him who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated and invite the children to join me around the Advent candles as our first Advent candles are lit and we sing our hymn of light, O Come, Emmanuel.
Blessed are you, O Lord our God, ruler of the universe. You call all nations to walk in you and to seek your ways of peace and justice. For night is past and the dawning of your coming is near. As we light this candle, rouse up from your sleep and kindle in us the fire of your justice and righteousness, that when you come, we will welcome you in our hearts and homes, for you are our light and salvation.
Blessed be God forever.
Light one candle to watch for Messiah.
A reading from the book of Jeremiah. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will fulfill the promise I made to the house of Israel and the house of Judah. In those days and at that time, I will cause a righteous branch to spring up for David, and he shall execute justice and righteousness in the land. In those days, Judah will be saved, and Jerusalem will live in safety. And this is the name by which it will be called: the Lord is our righteousness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. There will be signs in the sun, the moon, and the stars, and on the earth distress among nations confused by the roaring of the sea and the waves. People will faint from fear and foreboding of what is coming upon the world, for the powers of the heavens will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. Now when these things begin to take place, stand up, raise your hands, raise your heads, because your redemption is drawing near. Then he told them a parable. Look at the fig tree and all the trees. As soon as they sprout leaves, you can see for yourselves and know that summer is already near. So also, when you see these things taking place, you know that the kingdom of God is near. Truly I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. Be on guard so that your hearts are not weighed down with dissipation and drunkenness and the worries of this life, and that day catch you unexpectedly like a trap. For it will come upon all who live on the face of the whole earth. Be alert at all times, praying that you may have the strength to escape all these things that will take place and to stand before the Son of Man. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Speak in the name of our life-giving, loving, and liberating Lord, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Be seated. Now joining with peoples of all times and tribes and tongues, we profess our faith in a sung version of the Nicene Creed, a version that comes to us from the Kenyan people. We sing Nina Siddiqui, which means, I believe.
I believe in God the Almighty, Nina Siddiqui, who created earth and the heavens, Nina God's Son from heaven, Nina Sadiki, of eternal love the begotten, Nina Sadiki, and conceived by the Holy Spirit, Nina Sadiki. He was born of the Virgin Mary, Nina Sadiki. To the earth he came as a baby, Nina. Thank you.
During the season of Advent, we have an opportunity to offer our prayers in a visual and a tangible manner. In the pew racks in front of you, you will see strips of construction paper, which are blue and purple. We invite you to write your prayers on those strips of construction paper. And as you prepare to come forward during communion, you will have an opportunity to place those strips of construction paper in two black wire baskets on either side of the choir platform. Later on in the week, members of the Daughters of the King will take those prayers and insert them in glass ornaments, and those ornaments will be placed on our two Advent trees. One member of the church affectionately calls them prayers in a bauble, and then on Christmas Eve, the trees are lit, and indeed, the hopes and dreams of all the years are met in thee tonight. So we invite you to participate in this wonderfully tangible and unique way of offering our prayers to Almighty God. Now please receive the words for the peace. God will speak peace to his people, to those who turn to him with their hearts. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us share that peace and love with those around us. Good to see all of you here in this place of prayer and praise, and remind you, if you've not had an opportunity already to fill out the Canterbury Connection cards that are included in your bulletin, encourage you to do so. We do each and every week so that we might indeed acknowledge your worshiping attendance with us, especially if you're worshiping with us for the first time. Thank you so much. Now, my friends, ascribe to the Lord the honor due God's name. Bring offerings and come into God's courts with praise.
body here, like Mary a-weeping. Call on my Jesus and he'll draw nigh. Is there anybody here like Mary a-weeping? Call on my Jesus and he'll draw nigh. Glory, 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 glory be to my God on high. Glory, 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 call on my Jesus and he'll draw nigh. Is there anybody here like jailers a-trembling? Call on my Jesus and he'll draw nigh. Is there anybody here like jailers a-trembling? Call on my Jesus and he'll draw nigh. Glory, 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 glory be to my God on high. Glory, 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 call on my Jesus and he'll draw nigh. Is there anybody here like Peter a-sinking? Call on my Jesus and he'll draw nigh.
Is there anybody,
here like Peter? Call on my Jesus and he'll draw nigh. Glory, 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 glory be to my God on high. Glory, 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 call on my Jesus and he'll draw nigh. Glory, 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 glory be to my God on high. Glory, 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 call on my Jesus and he'll draw nigh. Is there anybody here like Mary a-weeping? Call on my Jesus and he'll draw nigh.
Great Thanksgiving begins on page 10 in your bulletin.
The Lord be with you. God and Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son, for he humbled himself to come among us in human flesh. He fulfilled the plan you formed before the foundation of the world to open for us the way of salvation. Confident that your promise will be fulfilled, we now watch for the day when Christ our Lord will come again in glory. And so we join our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven to proclaim your glory, evermore praising you as we sing. As a light to the nations, you delivered them from bondage and led them to a land of promise. Of your grace, you gave Jesus to be human, to share our life, to proclaim the coming of your holy reign, and to give himself for us a fragrant offering. Through Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, you have freed us from sin, brought us into your life, reconciled us to you, and restored us to the glory you intend for us. We thank you that on the night before he died, Jesus took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his friends and said, "Take, eat, this is my body broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Jesus took the cup of wine, said the blessing, and gave it to his friends and said, "Drink this, all of you. This cup is a new covenant in my blood, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." The resurrection and ascension, longing for Christ's coming in glory and presenting to you these gifts your earth has formed and human hands have made. We acclaim you, O Christ. Dying, you destroyed our dead. Rising, you restored our life. Christ Jesus, come in glory.
Send your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts of bread and wine, that they may be to us the body and blood of your Christ. Grant that we, burning with your Spirit's power, may be a people of hope, justice, and love. Giver of life, draw us together in the body of Christ, and in the fullness of time, gather us with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Saint Joseph, her spouse, Saint Augustine of Canterbury, and all your people into the joy of our true and eternal home. Through Christ, and with Christ, and in Christ, by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, we worship you, our God and Creator, in voices of unending praise. Blessed are you, now and forever. Amen. Now, joining hands and hearts and voices, we pray in the words in which our Savior taught us, saying, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Of God, for you, the people of God, take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with great thanksgiving. May we see you.
Reminder on how we will distribute communion at this Lord's table on this Lord's day. In a few moments, you will be invited to come forward at the direction of the ushers, beginning on the sides and the transepts. You will make your way across the back, down the center aisle to receive the bread and wine of this Eucharistic feast. I'll remind you, if you have prayer slips, please deposit them in the black wicker baskets on either side of the choir platform. As you come forward, if you wish to receive communion via intinction, the bread dipped in the wine, please receive a napkin from one of our two ushers. After consuming that bread, which has been dipped in the wine, please place the napkins in one of the two wicker baskets on either side of the altar so that we might reverently dispose of those napkins after our worship is completed. If you wish to receive bread only, it's not necessary for you to receive a napkin. Simply come forward, arms extended, palms up. A piece of bread will be placed in the palm of your hand, and you can consume it. For those of you who wish to receive from the common cup, the chalice, as I've mentioned time and time again, we've returned to that most ancient and venerable tradition. Encourage you to do so. There'll be two chalice bearers on the outside of the wicker baskets. Please help and guide the chalice to your lips. These are large chalices, which we use during the season of Advent. And ladies, if you have lipstick, we'd ask that you kindly please use a Kleenex to blot the lipstick before receiving the chalice. Altar Guild will be greatly appreciative of that. Please note that gluten-free bread is available for those of you who request it. And even if you aren't going to receive communion, we still invite you to come forward to receive a blessing. Simply cross your arms over your chest and you'll be given the assurance of God's presence in your life. This feast is indeed a foretaste of the wonderful feast of the Lamb. We invite you to come forward and to taste and see that the Lord is good.
To A time to reap, a time to kill, a time to heal, a time to laugh, a time to weep. To everything, turn, turn, turn. There is a season, turn, turn, turn. And a time to every purpose under heaven. A time to build up, a time to break down, a time to dance, a time to mourn. A time to cast away stones, a time to gather stones together. Season, turn, 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 and a time to every purpose under heaven. A time of love, a time of hate, a time of war, a time of peace. A time you may embrace, a time to refrain. Season, turn, 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 and the time to every purpose under heaven. A time to gain, a time to lose, a time to mend, a time to sow, a time for love, a time for hate, a time for peace. I swear it's not too late. To everything, turn, turn, turn. There is a season, turn, turn, turn. And a time to every purpose under heaven. To everything, turn, turn, turn. There is a season, turn, 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 and a time to every purpose under heaven, under heaven, under heaven, turn, 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 under heaven, turn, 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 under heaven. Turn, 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 under heaven, turn, turn, turn.
Thank you.
page 13 in your bulletin, let us pray and say together our post-communion prayer. Together. O Lord our God, make us watchful and keep us faithful as we await the coming of your Son, our Lord, that when he shall appear, he may not find us sleeping in sin, but active in his service and joyful in his praise, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please be seated for a moment.
In my sermon, I mentioned that there is distress and heartache, destruction, and despair. That's what's taking place in the world around us. Warfare in the Holy Land. But I also mentioned that we are an Advent people, and so we hold on to hope. We dare to go out into the world and be countercultural. We believe that Jesus Christ is his kingdom is breaking in our midst. We pray for the fulfillment of Christ's kingdom. In the midst of all that's taking place in the world, we know that our brothers and sisters in the Holy Land are constantly barraged by warfare and devastation. When I left my former cure, Trinity Episcopal Church in Tulsa, one of the farewell gifts that was given to me was a gift to the Holy Land. It just so happens it took place the same time that Bishop Ed was putting together the first group from the Diocese of Oklahoma to go to, as Iyad, our tour guide, called the Land of the Holy One. And I got a chance to walk places where Jesus walked. And it changed my life. And several years later, we had an opportunity to have a relationship with Shepherd Field, a group that makes wonderful artifacts, crosses, and statues from olive wood there in the Holy Land. And as you made your way into the church today, no doubt you saw all of those items that have been made beautifully from olive wood. And I ask you the question, if you've already had an opportunity to engage in your Christmas shopping, and most of you said no. And so here's a wonderful opportunity for you to do some Christmas shopping during Advent. Buy something for yourself or a family member or friend. And I invite our sister to come forward and to have a word with us about the wonderful things that you have brought to St. Augustine. So I invite you to come to the Ambo and speak to this group.
Good afternoon. My name is Selwa, and I am from Bethlehem with the Shepherd's Field Group from the Holy Land. I've been working for this for like 15 years, but I never had these issues before because we used to help our brothers and sisters in the Holy Land. But the demand right now, it's more because of the war in Gaza, most of the people are not working in Bethlehem. Because most of them are working with the tourism who visit the country, and right now nobody is visiting Bethlehem. If you go to visit the Nativity Church, it used to be the line like maybe 2 miles. Right now it's empty. Nobody's visiting the country. So our sales here in the churches is the most important things to help our brothers and sisters to stay alive in the Holy Land. And by your purchase, which is very important to help our brothers and sisters to stay alive, you will helping them to stay in Bethlehem and to stay alive also. So if you please, I need you to come and see what we have. Just visit us. If you need to just to make a visit to me, I will be very glad to speak about the Holy Land with you. And if you like to buy something, that will be very generous from you. And thank you, Father, for hosting us today. I appreciate that. And on behalf of the Christians in Bethlehem, we would like to give this beautiful cross to St. Augustine Parish. Thank you, and God bless you.
Remind you that immediately following the blessing and the dismissal, we have our Las Posadas potluck, opportunity for us to send Mary and Joseph on their way throughout this wonderful community of faith. Invite you to come and enjoy each other's presence and fellowship and fun. Also an opportunity for you to make your Advent wreaths or take the greens and the foam and the candles with you. So we'll have an opportunity to continue our celebrating in the parish hall. Please stand and receive the blessing. May Almighty God, by whose providence our Savior Christ came among us in great humility, sanctify you with the light of his blessing and set you free from all sin. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you, remain with you, and those whom you love, now and forever.
Amen. As we wait our coming, Savior, go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.